carbon capture and storage is a technique to, if you burn a fuel, or be just before you burn it, you take the carbon out, you filter it out. So you get the energy out of the fuel, but you also separately capture the carbon, for instance, as CO2. And there are ways then to pump that, for instance, if you're close to an old oil field, to pump it underground and to store it there. Carbon capture and storage is one of those techniques which we can use to mitigate our influence on the climate system. So, because we are using energy anyways, we should find ways to make it less carbon intensive. And one way is to go for renewables. Another way is to, if we use fossil fuels, to take the carbon out and prevent it from coming in the atmosphere. So it has been part of the whole toolbox to deal with climate change emissions and getting them down. At the same time, the policymakers then have to think about, where do we do this? Can we do this under populated areas? How do we get the CO2 to where it then needs to be pumped on the underground? So there are all sorts of analysis questions, political questions that have to be answered before you can really do this at a large scale. Bioenergy is using sunlight to grow plants and store energy in the plants and then process those plants to make a fuel. Simplest example being alcohol, which you can, at large scale, they do it in Brazil, they grow plants and they get alcohol out of that, out of corn. In that way, what you do is, in producing the fuel, you're first taking the carbon out of the atmosphere, and then you're using the fuel, and then it's going back into the atmosphere. So, in the net, it's a zero emission technology. So the main issue with biofuels at the moment is that they are not attractive enough. The ones that we can produce, that they most easily the first generation, they don't deliver sufficient environmental benefits yet. The next generations are in a stage where there have been researched and studied, but in terms of manufacturing them at large scale and going to a sufficiently low price to make it attractive, we're not there yet. But that's a matter of time, so it's still in niches before it really will grow into something mainstream. Still, you have to realize it will only be for particular sectors. It will be a very attractive solution. So I don't think it will be the general solution for supplying all our electricity, for instance, but it can be very attractive for dealing with transport. Bioenergy and carbon capture and storage in a combination is a very interesting example of where energy, technology and climate policy meet, because what we have seen in terms of being able to meet our 2 degrees goal, in the further future we will have to go to net negative emissions. So we will have to take carbon out of the atmosphere if we look into what's already coming down the line. So we have to think about what are ways to do that. And one way to do that is to create biofuels, to take carbon out of the atmosphere and grow fuels from that, and then before we use them, or while we use them, while we burn them, take the carbon out of those fuels and store those underground. So then you have, then it's not what we were aiming for with biofuels, a zero emission, but it's a negative emissions technology. So that's attractive because it may help us meet our climate targets. There's also questions and issues in terms of how much of those biofuels can we grow. What is needed in the models is pretty much in terms of negative emissions, and there's real questions on the sustainability, the issues related to food and agriculture and biodiversity if we want to go to such large numbers. So we have to really think about where do we use that and where do we not use that, and we have to use other techniques.